This is Funny. You are watching Funny Just Info. Today I am going to talk about Factories Act Chapter 4A, provisions relating to the hazardous process. In general terms, the word hazardous is not new to anyone. Generally, it means dangerous. If talk about the dangerous hazardous process, then it means the process which may cause damage to life or health. In terms of laws, hazardous process means any process or activity in relation to an industry where, unless special care is taken, raw materials used therein or the intermediate or finished products or byproducts, wastes or effluents thereof would cause material impairment to the health of the person, result in pollution or general environment. In this session, we look at the various rules and provisions related to the hazardous process in the Factories Act 1948. These chapters include from section 41A to 41H. They are constitution of site appraisal committees, compulsory disclosure of information by occupier, specific responsibilities of the occupier in relation of hazardous process, power of central government to appoint inquiry committee, emergency standards, permissible limits of exposure of chemicals and toxic substances, workers' participation in safety management, and rights of the workers to warn about imminent danger. Let me brief these sections one by one. Section 41A, Constitution of Site Appraisal Committees. This section states that a factory should appoint a site appraisal committee consisting. The committee will be responsible for suggesting the location of the factory which includes hazardous process. This committee will include the chief inspector of the state, the representative of the central board for the prevention and control of water pollution, a representative of Department of Environment in the state, representative of Meteorological Department of the Government of India, an expert in field of occupational health, a representative of town planning department of the state government. Section 41B, compulsory disclosure of information by the occupier. This section states that, firstly, the occupier of every factory involving the hazardous process shall disclose in the prescribed manner all information regarding the dangers and measures to overcome the same. Secondly, the occupier shall, at the time of registration, the factory lay down a detailed policy with respect to health and safety of the workers. Thirdly, the information should be completely accurate. And lastly, every occupier shall, with approval of chief inspector, draw up an on-site emergency plan. He should also draw up a detailed disaster control measuring for the factory. Moreover, the factory should announce it to all workers and the public in general. Next one, section 41C, specific responsibilities of the occupier in relation to the hazardous process. This section states that every occupier of the factory involving in any hazardous process accurately maintain the health and medical records of all workers in the factory. It is mainly those workers who are working in the manufacturing of toxic or harmful substances. Appoint a person who possesses qualification and experience in handling hazardous substances. They should also be competent to supervise such handling within the factory. Moreover, they should provide all necessary facilities for protecting the workers in the manner prescribed. And provide for medical examination for every workers before assigning any production task involving the hazardous substance. Next one, section 41D, power of central government to appoint an inquiry committee. This section states that the central government in some extraordinary situations may appoint an inquiry committee for the factory manufacturing hazardous material. They inquire to the standards of health and safety observed in the factory. They do so to find out the causes of any failure or neglect in the adopt of all measures or standards. Moreover, the committee should consist of a chairman and two other members. The central government determines the tenure of the members. Also, the recommendations of the committee shall be advisory in nature. Section 41E, Emergency Standards. This section states that in certain cases, when the central government thinks that factory is unable to apply certain security measures, then it is allowed to direct the director in charge of the factory to implement the measures or standards on the immediate basis. This is mainly applies to the factories involving the production of hazardous substances. Section 41F, Permissible Limit of Exposure of Chemicals and Toxic Substances. This section states that firstly, the maximum permissible threshold limit of exposure of chemical substances should be as per Schedule 2. Secondly, the central government may at any time, for the purpose of giving effect any scientific proof, may make suitable changes in said schedule. Section 41G, Workers' Participation in the Safety Management. This section states that the occupier shall, in every factory where the hazardous process takes place, should set up a safety committee. This safety will comprise an equal number of representatives of workers and management. It is mainly formed to promote cooperation between workers and management in maintaining safety and perfect health at work. Section 41H, Right of the workers to warn about imminent danger. Section 41H gives the right of the workers of a factory in which a hazardous process takes place to bring to the notice of the occupier, agent, manager, or any other person who is in charge of the factory or inspector of the area of their apprehension about imminent danger, and person or persons informed must be inquired immediately on receipt of information and take remedial action. This is about Chapter 4A of Factories Act. Let me summarize this chapter. A new Chapter 4A inserted in the Act, the Factories Act 1987, has inserted this new chapter in the Act after Chapter 4. The new chapter lays down provisions relating to the hazardous process in Sections 41A to 41H. Thanks for watching and have a safe day.